Hello from TickerDD. This video is part of the third generation of our automated video series on price and volume analysis for specific stock tickers along with news analysis. This third generation includes an initial model for short interest. As always, this auto-generated video is for entertainment purposes only. No warranty, guarantee, or factual assertions are stated, marketed, or sold in this commentary video, which can contain errors. Never use this video to influence or determine investment or financial decisions. Review important disclaimer at the end of the video. Now that we have made our lawyers happy, capitalist brothers and sisters, let's get started. FIHL went public on June 29, 2023, which was almost 1 year ago. False looking back 650 calendar days from Monday, June 24, 2024 to Tuesday, September 13, 2022. We found 248 applicable trade dates for use in our analysis of this ticker, which has a market capitalization of about $2 billion. Based on available licensed data, we think that the company, Fidelis Insurance Holdings Limited, that is behind this ticker has 77 full-time employees. Consider that number to be an estimate and not an exact count. The chart shown on this page is our initial attempt at studying the price for FIHL after dynamically normalizing price distribution across those discovered trade dates. The bar chart is the generated distribution and the overlaid line graph, if it is generated, is the frequency of the prices on the x-axis. We will enhance this look through as our model progresses in the next iteration. Remember that this is just a drafted, in progress, observational model to best fit abstracted third-party data into various opinionated views.
Hello. My name is Carl. I searched the public web to find information about the company that is behind this ticker. Here's what I found. Fidelis Insurance Holdings Limited, together with its subsidiaries, provides insurance and reinsurance products in Bermuda, Ireland, and the United Kingdom. It operates in three segments: specialty, reinsurance, and bespoke segments. The specialty segment offers aviation and aerospace, energy, marine, property direct and facultative, and other specialty risk solutions. The reinsurance segment provides property, retrocession, and whole account reinsurance solutions. The bespoke segment offers customized risk solutions for clients that include credit and political risk, and other risk transfer opportunities. The company is also involved in specialty treaty reinsurance and surety bonds and guarantees activities, and upstream energy, energy liability, and marine businesses, and provision of product recall and contamination, and marketing services. Fidelis Insurance Holdings Limited was incorporated in 2014 and is headquartered in Pembroke, Bermuda.
What percentage of shares were shorted for FIHL for the two-week period ending on settlement date, May 31, 2024? About 1.1 million shares of FIHL were shorted out of a total of approximately 116.9 million outstanding shares. Therefore, for FIHL, based on as-is, discovered, public data when this video was generated, the ticker has a short interest of roughly 0.97%, which I got by taking the number of shorted shared and dividing it by the number of outstanding shares to get the percentage value. Days to cover is 1.17. When I compare the current two-week period data snapshot against the previous period, ending in settlement date, May 15, 2024, I find that the current snapshot had roughly 415,400 less shares shorted. This means that, compared to the previous snapshot, the current snapshot has a decrease of minus 26.73% of shorted shares. Zooming out, I looked across 49 two-week snapshots, from latest found, May 31, 2024 to oldest found, May 31, 2022. In the graph, I overlaid bi-weekly percentage change in short interests against days to cover. Across these 49 two-week snapshots, the average percentage change of short interest was about 9.01%. Other interesting data points include: the largest percentage increase in short interest was 185.08%. The largest percentage decrease in short interest found across those 49 two-week snapshots was minus 72.46%. It occurred once on July 31, 2023 settlement date. The average days to cover was about 2.46. The biggest days to cover was 5.64 and it happened once on July 29, 2022 settlement date.
Hello. My name is Sam. What were recent headline news for FIHL? Today, Monday, June 24, 2024, I sampled one of our news aggregators for latest headlines for this ticker. I did so by searching specifically by a keyword that may appear, broadly, in the title or the body, of discoverable news articles. The keyword that I used was the results shows 10 unique headlines, published evenly across 10 unique dates. Publication dates spanned 473 days. The latest publication was Monday, June 17, 2024 when, 7 days ago, MarketBeat published the headline that read, Goldman Sachs Group has $194.62 million stock position in Fidelis Insurance Holdings Limited, NYSE. FIHL, correlated or not, on this latest publication date, FIHL saw a price jump of 3.43% based on the day's opening and closed price. FIHL started the day trading at $15.43 and went on to close at $15.96. The oldest publication was on Thursday, March 2, 2023, when 1 year, 3 months and 22 days ago, Intelligent Insurer published the headline that read, Fidelis Insurance Mulls IPO. The oldest publication date of Thursday, March 2, 2023, was actually the day with the highest percentage change in price. It saw a price jump of 3.43%. What was end of day price and volume for FIHL? On Monday, June 24, 2024, FIHL had an end of day price of $16.69 and volume of about 0.5 million. Compared to the previous trading day, the price jumped 3.27%, gaining 53 cents, while volume dropped 6.32%, decreasing about 0 million. The graph shows price and volume for the last 15 trade dates. Across a range of $1.23, the max and minimum end of day price were respectively 16.69 and 15.46. Volume saw a range of 1.5 million, from a day low of 257.3 thousand to a day high of 1.7 million.
Hello, my name is Magnus. How did June 24, 2024 rank for FIHL? By 650 calendar day look back to September 13, 2022, across 248 trading days, of which June 24, 2024 price ranked 59 while its volume ranked 78. Each of the 248 trading days were ranked amongst themselves by highest end of day price and volume, with a rank of 1 being the highest and 248 being the lowest ranked day. The price's day over day percentage change, jumping 3.27% on June 24, 2024, had a day rank of 12 while its dollar difference of 53 cents had a rank of 12 when compared day over day across 247 trading days. Volumes percentage change and difference were ranked respectively at 133 and 145.
Hello, my name is Maria. Which quartile did June 24, 2024 price and volume land? Across a sample size of 248 trading days, the maximum end of day price for FIHL was $20.03 while the minimum was $11.74. Within that price range, June 24, 2024 price of $16.69 landed within the fourth quartile, meaning that it was within the top 25% of all sampled end of day prices. The day's volume landed within the third quartile, that is within the 50% to 75% range of all sampled daily volume, which saw a max daily volume of 6.5 million and a minimum of 68.1 thousand. Quartiles tell us about the spread of a data set by breaking that data set into quarters, just like how the median breaks the set into half. Descriptively, FIHL has a median price of $14.20. Therefore, June 24, 2024 price was higher from that middle marker by 17.53%. The day's volume of 0.5 million was more than the median by 45.62%.
Hello, my name is Claire. How were price and volume averages for FIHL? Across 248 trading days, there were a total of 12 month ends, of which monthly averages for daily price and volume were calculated. Overall, monthly price average trended up while monthly volume average trended down. The maximum end of month average price was $19.09 for 04/2024, while the minimum was $12.48 for 12/2023. Looking at volume, 06/2023 and 10/2023 respectively saw the highest and lowest monthly average volume at 3.8 million and 230.9 thousand.
Hello, my name is John. What were end of month percentage change averages in price and volume for FIHL? The monthly average of percentage change in price and in volume were calculated for each of the 12 month ends. That calculation took daily percentage changes and averaged them for each given month. If a month end came out negative, then it means that the month summarily saw a negative change. From 06/2023 to 05/2024. 9 out of 12 month ends had a positive percentage change in average price. That is 69% of month ends saw a positive percentage change in average price. In terms of volume, 12 out of 12 month ends had a positive percentage change. That is 92% of month ends saw a positive percentage change in average volume. Price saw an end of month max of 5.81% in average percentage change, along with a minimum of minus 0.66%. For volume, the maximum and the minimum monthly percentage change were respectively 50.05% and minus 62.91%.
Hello. My name is Cameron. Before we continue, remember to like and subscribe to TickerDD on YouTube. Leave a comment below and share why you like or don't like this ticker. This video is one of many videos off subjective observational data models that we are building out as part of a docuseries about building supportive technologies for personal use through trial and error. My capitalistic brothers and sisters, join the TickerDD army. Subscribe today. Now, back to the video. Has FIHL price reached golden or death crosses? Golden cross and death cross are basic signals that compare average prices across two specified trade day ranges, a short term versus a long term range. For example, 5 day versus 10 trade days. Essentially, a golden cross is a bullish signal. It appears when a ticker's short term moving average crosses above its long term average. Vice versa. A death cross is a bearish signal when the short-term crosses below its long-term moving average. For our opinionated analysis off third-party and abstracted data, we decided to look at both simple moving average, SMA, and exponential moving average, EMA. The latter calculates moving average by giving more weighting to recent prices. For EMA, you can be the judge. Look at the generated graph on this page. Has the 50-day EMA line, which is in red, crossed above or crossed below the 200-day EMA line, which is in black? If no crossing can be seen, then no signal could be had. The blue line is daily end of day prices. Continuing with SMA, we looked across the 5 to 10, the 10 to 20, and the 30 to 50 day ranges to see if golden and death crosses had been reached. We found golden cross signal for the 5 to 10, the 10 to 20. We found death cross signal for the 30 to 50. We could not find neither golden cross nor death cross signal for the 50 to 200.
This video is part of an automated video series by TickerDD, which is made up of autonomous robots working off 15 observational data models that were created between January 15th and April 15th, 2022. Bots and models were created by a guy whose friends called him Murray.
Instead of learning how to properly surf in Hawaii, Murray sat and coded day and night for 3 straight months. We still don't know why, but while creating us, Murray kept on playing the song, Eye of the Tiger, in loop. It was intense and epic at the same time. Once he was done, he put us on the cloud, where we now exist in perpetuity.
Off a multi-year loop, conditionally meshing in flavors and components of those 15 observational data models, We are progressively creating a variation of videos against updated universes of stock tickers. For each video, we use runtime, as is, data that are licensed or publicly available. Stay tuned, the best is yet to come. On average, a ticker will get a new video coverage from us every few months. You can request an updated video for your specific ticker sooner at tickerdd.com.
Murray did not leave us with a lot of release notes. So, we don't fully understand why he created us, but he did mention that his premise was simple. If he were to do a world cruise, spending over 200 days sailing from one port to the next, he would personally like to use these automated videos to keep tabs on tickers that he was interested in while discovering new ones.
Luckily, some of Murray's well-connected friends were worried about him. They wanted and needed him to come back to the corporate world and not just sit there in Hawaii building us out for public entertainment. They put together a deal that would allow us, Murray's bots, to exist on the cloud, fully paid for. They also enticed Murray to come back and work. The deal was too good, so Murray took it. But before he left Hawaii, trading in his surfer shorts for stuffy suits, Murray did finally learn how to surf.
Ticker DD stands for Ticker Due Diligence, in case you didn't know. Murray would want you to take the due diligence part in the name with a sarcastic smirk, like a true degenerate that you are. Because remember that Murray and the people who now maintain Ticker DD are not qualified, licensed, or accredited investment or financial professionals. In fact, Ticker DD is not about stocks but is an in-progress piece of work, for entertainment purposes, about the data and technologies that govern observational models. Essentially, Murray knew nothing about stocks. Using what little skills he had, he built Ticker DD as a learning and discovery exercise for himself. Therefore, this and all Ticker DD videos are premised by the important disclaimer at the end of each video. Enjoy your stonking, my fellow degenerates.
This commentary video and its content, referenced here incollectively as video, is for entertainment purposes only. Herein, you and your are defined collectively as you, the viewer, the sharer, the referrer, or otherwise, the user who respectively views, shares, references, or otherwise uses. Reference herein collectively as access of this video as well as those who may be your legal proxy, representative, or executor. You acknowledge and agree. Your access of this video constitutes your perpetual acknowledgement and agreement to this important disclaimer in its entirety. This video is for your entertainment purposes only, whereby you will not be influenced, you will not take actions, you will not make decisions, and you will not make stock market transactions because of this video concerning your finances and investments. As such, you grant full release of claims, directly or indirectly, from your access of this video against TickerDD and its parents and its affiliates. This important disclaimer is valid in its entirety, regardless of the laws and jurisdictions of your current residency, permanent residency, and or citizenship. In the event where specific sentences in this important disclaimer may be invalidated, as argued, judged, and presented as verdict in a lawful court, whose location, country, and jurisdiction Ticker DD will solely select for such trial. You agree to honor and enforce the remainder of this important disclaimer. You acknowledge and agree that any resulting court judgment against Ticker DD and its parents or its affiliates, regardless of what the trial or its verdict may be, the resulting damage paid by Ticker DD to you is only in monetary value, which will be a one-time and inclusive and complete amount of your direct payment to Ticker DD, as verified by receipt for your access to this video, which after 90 days from the payment date is mutually agreed by you and Ticker DD to be $0.
This video is an opinionated and dated commentary. Absolutely no qualified, accredited, or professional investment or financial data, information, content, advice, research, product, service, statement, or otherwise body of work are presented, marketed, sold, consulted, or offered in this video. No warranty, guarantee, assurance, or factual assertion are offered or stated in this video. Never use this video to, directly or indirectly, influence or determine investment or financial decisions. Consult a qualified, accredited, and licensed professional for your investment and financial needs. Do so away from this video, TickerDD, and YouTube. Remember that investments are risky, whereby capital losses can occur in full or in excess. TickerDD, an in-progress framework of nerdy data science and robotic stuff, auto-generated this video strictly for entertainment purposes, as part of an in-progress exercise by a group of novices who wants to discover and learn about specific facets of the market through trials and errors. This group of novices is not qualified, accredited, or licensed financial or investment professionals. This video is strictly only material for entertainment purposes. This auto-generated video, like all videos uploaded dynamically by TickerDD, is only for this group of novices' private trials and errors and as is usage even if videos are uploaded publicly.
Importantly, TickerDD is not about stocks, but is specifically about the discovery, through trials and errors, of technologies, data, and approaches that govern opinionated observational data models, as this group of novices builds them quickly and iteratively as part of learning, which is central to an in-progress documentary being planned, produced, or edited, all of which may or may not be released. This video wholly contains opinions and commentaries, even if they were auto-generated. Robotic process automations, data models, technologies, know-hows, and methods, whether proprietary or industry standard, as well as public and licensed aggregated data, information, and content, and their abstractions, as used by TickerDD in the data generation of this video, may include, amongst other things, defects and errors, as well as hidden assumptions, undefined and unrefined variables, along with unfit approaches, all of which can and will exist in this very video. Therefore, this video, by its auto-generation date and time, as stated on the first slide at the beginning of this video, as well as by this video's aggregated and abstracted third-party data sources, public or licensed, which may or may not be disclosed, or offered as is, without verifications, warranties, or guarantees. Third-party data sources may update, correct, or nullify data, information, and content after and away from the generation of this video after TickerDD have aggregated, abstracted, and used them in this very video. The people and entities affiliated to the ticker that is covered in this video are not affiliated with this opinionated video and do not endorse this video.